There's a very interesting discussion about who God is, how many God is, and who Jesus is in relation to the one God in a short interview with Dr. Piper. He's asked the direct question, a very good question, incidentally, did the Old Testament present a triune God? Did Old Testament Jews believe in the triune God? And he responds, after some deliberation with himself, not with any clarity. And then he goes on to say, yes, they did believe in the triune God. This seems to me like sheer contradiction. It really is an enormous anachronism, taking things totally out of their historical context, to say that Jews believed in a Trinitarian or triune God. It's known, I think, to most historians and many theologians that they definitely did not. If we say that they did, then we impugn the whole of the Jewish tradition. They were taught systematically that God is not triune, not biune, but simply one God. Now, when we get to the New Testament, Dr. Piper says, well, Revelation was progressive, and so the Trinity is unfolded in the New Testament. But my question to that point of view is simply this. Did Jesus believe in the Trinitarian God? If so, why is he citing the very creed that was given to Israel, which is plainly a Unitarian creed? Jesus is asked in Mark 12, do you believe in one God or not? The Jew is checking up on Jesus, and Jesus recites the Shema, affirms it plainly, in the strongest possible terms. This is the most important thing you can believe. So if Jesus had not moved from the Unitarian Shema to the Trinitarian God, why are we claiming to follow Jesus while discarding, laying aside, overlooking his explicit creed given in Mark chapter 12, verse 29? Dr. Piper then goes on to point out, and it's an excellent point, that Jesus had a favorite psalm, a favorite verse in the Psalms, in fact, and that's Psalm 110, verse 1. Jesus appeals to this psalm, as does the rest of the New Testament, many times, to make the point about the relationship between Yahweh, the one God, and the Messiah. Now, had Dr. Piper unpacked that psalm a little further, it really would have exploded and destroyed his whole plea to believe in the Trinity on the basis of Scripture, because in that psalm, Yahweh speaks to somebody who is not Yahweh, and that someone who is the Messiah, according to Jesus, and rightly so, of course, that someone is Adonai, my Lord. Now that word Adonai is not a deity title. How very easily Jesus could have said, well, David said, Yahweh speaks to Adonai, that's God speaks to God. And you'd have at least two-thirds of a triune God there. But that is expressly not what that text says. Jesus cites as authoritative Psalm 110:1, and he plainly then implies exactly what the Hebrew text tells us there. Namely that Adonai, my Lord, is the non-deity title all 195 times that it appears in Scripture. It never applies to God. It's the one title which tells you you're not talking about God, you're talking about an infinitely superior human being, occasionally an angel, but expressly not God. Why didn't Dr. Piper investigate that psalm, having admitted that it's the favorite psalm of Jesus and the New Testament?